Hey guys, it's Pope. To start out this vlog today, I want to pass along some information from BetterHelp. I have partnered up with them to give my viewers on the YouTube channel and my followers on Instagram and whatnot an opportunity to learn about this service, which is online counseling. I talk a lot about mental health, and I've actually been featured in a mental health book, and I myself have struggled with pretty severe anxiety in the past, so a service like this would have been helpful at that time. But I actually reached out and did some in-person therapy work, and I've actually worked with a sports psychologist before to deal with my anxiety in the gym. So I think this is a really great thing they have come up with, doing online therapy, because it's much cheaper, as little as $35 a week, which traditional therapy, I think I was paying like $200 a session for the sports psychologist. So I think that's really awesome that they're able to kind of cut all the overhead costs and be able to provide online remote therapy sessions. Super cool. And you also get to do it from your house. So if you're having any like trouble actually making yourself go to a therapist, but you feel like you need some help or could use some tools from a therapist to manage anything that you're dealing with, this is a great way to do that. I've included the link in my description, but once you go to this site, you can do it on your phone or the computer, you fill out like a questionnaire and tell it all about yourself, and then it matches you with a licensed therapist, and you can talk to them at any time and set up video conferences, and there's a lot of cool features to it. And they've already helped 600,000 people, so it's definitely a reputable service, and I just want to get the message spread out there that it's something that's available, because I know it could help a lot of people. There's a lot of tools out there, just working with my example, being anxiety and stress, not managing it well, that I think a lot of people are not even aware of. If you follow me like pretty closely on Instagram and whatnot, you have seen like the cuss word coloring books that I have. I do that a lot. I've been recently doing puzzles. I just finished a 1,000-piece puzzle. I found that these little tools help me in such a big way, and I think finding those things on your own can be difficult, especially if you're struggling in the moment. Having someone kind of guide you to the tools that will work best for you, I think, is the best thing that I personally have gotten from working with a therapist before. I also don't want there to be like this stigma out there that if you felt that you needed help at some point, that means you're like, something's wrong with you. Everyone needs help every now and then. And almost all of my friends have seen therapists before too, because it just gives you a little push that you need more so than anything, in my opinion. If that's something that interests you, check out the link in my description. And I just wanted to get all of the information out there. I've actually had kind of a tough day today. I was attending a funeral service, and while that was very sad, it was actually very beautiful because it was an army vet in the family, and it was a really cool experience to just see how much respect he had and how much the community of veterans, I guess it is, as a whole, just came together, and it just blew me away how beautiful the ceremony was. And especially the flag ceremony, it was just very moving, and it's been a pretty emotional day for me, but I need to get my workout in. It's kind of late, a little bit low on motivation right now, but I need to get it in. I've got some front squats and some snatches to do, so I'm gonna head out to the gym now. I'm filming this today because I don't want to only vlog on the days that I'm feeling super awesome. So today is more vlogging a day I'm not feeling great, but we're gonna get the work done anyways. Thank you. I made it through the workout. I'm gonna call that a win. My snatches were very slow today off the blocks. Front squats felt pretty good. My positions felt pretty strong today. Hanging out with Truffle, she was kind of in the way in one of my sets. I did 3 sets of 6 at 88 kilos. My legs have been super sore starting back training. I did a 1 day of 10 so far on the back squat and my legs got blown up so much. They're very sore, so front squats felt good considering how much DOMS I got going on in my quads right now. And I'm introducing a lot of exercises that I haven't seen in a while, like the bicycle squat that I finished up with 3 sets of 10, trying to really focus on my position there to be as upright as possible. And I'm also really working on quad engagement throughout the whole lift, trying to really focus on quad strength with those. A lot of people like the belt squat also for that, but with both of my hips having torn labrums, the belt squat just pinches my hips too much. That angle, for some reason, with the weight sitting straight down, just really bugs my hips, so I like the bicycle squat instead. We're just getting back into groove with lots of different exercises and lots of reps right now. Push press yesterday, I did a lot of volume on, so my shoulders are so sore. I think that's why the snatch felt slow today. John Coffey always used to say, grow or die, you will adapt. And this first week of high volume training again always is a bit tough for me, but second week things will start picking up and snowballing. And just gotta love the process a bit right now. Thanks for hanging out with me today with my workout. Started out in the daytime and now it's 8:30 p.m. so I turned the lights on, it's dark now. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Make sure you're subscribed to my channel so you don't miss out on any of my training vlogs leading into the USAW Nationals in May. I'm going to be heading out to Kansas City. See you guys in the next video. Bye.